eating and eating, yet still undernourished, feeling sick and lacking in energy? Don Colbert, board certified in family practice and a specialist in nutritional medicine, offers help. His proven and medically sound program of juice fasting cleanses the body right down to the cellular level, shedding toxic fat, restoring energy and vitality, and adding years to the lifespan of the average person. In easy-to-understand language, Dr. Colbert explains the toxic battle being waged in the human body and also offers alternative solutions for living free from cancer, heart and liver ailments, diabetes, and other debilitating diseases. We hope Toxic Relief, read by Steve Hiller, gives you the information you need to live a long and healthy life. Oasis Audio has adapted this audiobook from the book published by Strang Communications.
Our Toxic Earth. We live in a toxic world, a toxic planet that's taking a heavy toll on our bodies every day, whether we know it or not. Due to our technological advances since the Industrial Revolution, we've continued to pour dangerous chemicals and pollutants into our streams, soil, and air. At this moment, you probably have some amount of lead in your body, usually stored in your bones. All of us do. Most of us have small amounts of DDT, or its metabolite DDE, which is what it changes into during metabolism, in our fatty tissues. Existing environmental lead levels are at least 500 times greater than prehistoric levels. Not only is it difficult for the Earth to break down these chemicals, but it's also difficult for your body to detoxify or eliminate them efficiently. Many times we lack the enzymes required to metabolize them. Thus, these chemicals become stored in our bodies, especially in fatty tissues, and are even stored in our brain, which is made up of about 60% lipids, which are fat-like substances. Sick and toxic. If our Earth is sick and toxic, then there's a very good chance that most of us will be sick and toxic. Unfortunately, we're usually unable to smell, taste, see, or sense most of the toxic chemicals to which we're exposed on a daily basis. As a result, it becomes increasingly difficult to avoid exposure. Let's take a closer look at the toxins with which our bodies must deal in an ongoing way. Awash in chemical chaos. Our bodies are battling an onslaught of toxic chemicals of staggering proportions. In 1993 alone, more than 1,672,127,735 pounds of toxic chemicals were released into our air, according to the Environmental Protection Agency's Toxic Release Inventory of 1993. The air you breathe is polluted by exhaust from our cars, buses, trains, and planes, and by industrial air pollution from waste disposal, and more. Carbon monoxide makes up about half of our air pollutants. Most of this comes from fuel. This dangerous gas has been directly linked to heart disease. With each breath, toxic chemicals are actually being pumped by the heart into every cell in your body via the bloodstream. Industrial plants, incinerators, and hazardous waste sites release volatile organic chemicals. These may include benzene, formaldehyde, vinyl chloride, toluene, carbon tetrachloride, and other volatile organic chemicals. Many of these can cause cancer. Indoor pollution. If you think that pollution is only found out of doors, you're wrong. Indoor pollution is often more dangerous to your health than what you inhale outside. Let's look. Most people spend about 90% of their time inside homes, office buildings, restaurants, factories, and school buildings. In these places, indoor toxins, chemicals, and bacteria get trapped and recirculated throughout the heating and air conditioning systems of these structures and may create a much greater health risk. Today's buildings are much more airtight and well-insulated than they were years ago, making them vaults for germs, bacteria, and chemical toxins. Think you're safer because your office building is new? Well, I hate to be the one to inform you, but you couldn't be more wrong. Volatile organic chemicals such as benzene, stearine, carbon tetrachloride, and other chemicals are as much as 100 times greater in new buildings compared to the levels found outdoors. New buildings are the worst. Building materials emit gases into the air through a process known as outgassing. New carpets release formaldehyde. Paints release solvents such as toluene and formaldehyde. And furniture made from pressed wood releases formaldehyde into the air as well. Have you been experiencing headaches that get more severe at work? Are your eyes itchy, red, and watery? What about a sore throat, dizziness, nausea, and problems concentrating? These are just a few of the many symptoms associated with sick building syndrome. Other symptoms of sick building syndrome include nasal congestion, shortness of breath, problems with memory and concentration, fatigue, and itching. In addition, carpet glues, as well as particle board, which is also made from glues and chemicals that contain formaldehyde, commonly cause both fatigue and headaches. Are you breathing in bacteria, mold, and yeast? Sick building syndrome is not only caused by new materials. Airborne mold, bacteria, and poisons given off by yeast can also cause sick building syndrome. Many people remember the mysterious deaths in 1976 of 182 Legionnaires who were staying at a Philadelphia hotel while attending a conference. It was later determined that this group of people contracted pneumonia from Legionella bacteria that had contaminated the hotel's air conditioning system. Before this event, occurrences of sick building syndrome were virtually unheard of. Nevertheless, many, if not most, air conditioning units and heating systems contain some amount of mold. Significant amounts are frequently found in them, and the spores from that mold can travel throughout the building. Pesticide pollution. Dampness is not the only danger to a healthful indoor environment. Dangerous indoor pollution is also created with an ever-increasing use of pesticides, which can be found in some really surprising products. Believe it or not, pesticides can be found in disposable diapers, shampoos, air fresheners, mattresses, and carpets. You are being exposed to pesticides every day. You may even have had your home sprayed regularly with pesticides to control bugs. The most common pesticides in use today are of a variety called organophosphates. This group includes diazinon. Pesticides are easily absorbed into your body through contact with your skin, by breathing them into your lungs and ingesting them through your mouth. Even though your body is designed to eliminate such dangerous poisons, the sheer amount of them that you encounter daily is far more than your body was ever designed to deal with. Therefore, pesticides, their metabolites, and other dangerous toxins eventually build up in your body over time. And the greater the buildup, the more difficult it becomes for your body to eliminate them. When such residue of pesticides builds up in your body, you can begin to experience the following symptoms or diseases: memory loss, depression, anxiety, psychosis, other forms of mental illness, Parkinson's, and other forms of neurological degeneration, possibly hormone-sensitive cancers, such as breast and prostate cancer. Are you being forced to inhale secondhand smoke? Another powerful offender is cigarette smoke. The smoke from a burning cigarette, as it sits lid in an ashtray, contains a higher toxic concentration of gases than what the smoker actually inhales. Secondhand cigarette smoke contains cadmium, cyanide, lead, arsenic, tars, radioactive material, dioxin, which is a toxic pesticide, carbon monoxide, hydrogen cyanide, nitrogen oxides, nicotine, sulfur oxides, and about 4,000 other chemicals. Toxins in our food and land. Pesticides continue to be sprayed onto our land, subsequently making their way into our food supply. As we eat pesticide-tainted fruits and vegetables, and especially fatty meats, pesticides become stored in our fatty tissues, which not only include our adipose tissue, but also the brain, the breasts, and the prostate gland. Some of these dangerous substances are known to last for hundreds and even thousands of years before breaking down. DDT is an example of a chemical that doesn't break down. It was used in this country on a large scale from the early 1940s to 1972. It is an extremely dangerous poison that was banned in 1972 due to its devastating effect on wildlife, causing multiple abnormalities in the eggshells of many birds and deformities of reproductive organs of many other animals. In 1962, environmentalist Rachel Carson wrote a book called Silent Spring, which demonstrated the toxic and deadly effect that DDT has on our food chain. Carson warned us that if pesticides could have such harmful and dramatic effects on animals and birds, then their effects upon humans would be no different. Dairy products are one of the main sources of DDT in our diets, and freshwater fish is usually tainted with DDT and PCBs. Waxes that don't wash off. No doubt you've tried to wash off a shiny red apple or a dark green cucumber, only to find that it was covered with a layer of waxy film that's nearly impossible to wash off.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, Use the link in the video description.